Hello.
Hi, pretty lady.
What you doing?
Taking your advice and going through my stuff, trying to figure out what to get rid of. I'm going to see Dr. Proctor in a few days, and I'm pretty anxious because of my lack of progress since I last saw him. So Tina has suggested that I go through my old fat clothes. She seems to think that it'll help me realize just how far I've come. Not to mention, secretly, she wants her house clean.
I'm just trying to figure out how I'm gonna get there.
You can sit in my lap.
No. This will be so much easier once we're 100 pounds lighter.
Okay. Right? I'm trying to see what's too big for me.
A lot of this is too big for you now.
I'll be throwing these away. I don't know why I was saving them. Let me try this on for a second.
Get out of your way.
You're fine, babe. Oh, okay.
We could probably both get into that.
Wanna try?
Come on, just for fun. Just to see if we could both fit in it.
Gosh.
Look, put your arm through.
Okay. Hold on, it's gotta get... Damn. Dude.
There's like, two of us.
Oh my gosh.
For years, I hid behind big dresses, long dresses, because I didn't like people to see my legs or my stomach. And now it's surreal for me to see that I could have fit another person into that dress. Damn, girl, you lost another person.
You know, maybe you'll have a bigger weight loss than you think when you go see Dr. Proctor.
Maybe, but I've had some major stalls and I've had anxiety about even stepping on the scale. I guess I need to just buckle it up and say, Dr. Proctor, I'm here. And I'm ready to make things right.
Yeah, you have to.
I know it's time to face the music and actually go see Dr. Proctor. My biggest fear is putting the weight back on like Ashley did. That is definitely not a path that I want to go down ever.
You gotta deal with it.
Help me make room for Jackie's car.
All right.
Go try to push it.
The gas gauge in my van has been messing up. It's been telling me I've got gas, I ain't got gas. The car's been stalling out, but I can't afford to take it to a mechanic because right now, with my appointment with Dr. Proctor coming up, I have to buy healthy food. I have to make sure that I'm taking care of myself.
All right, come on, push. 1, 2, 3. Oh, I lost my pants. Stop it, Jay.
I can't stop it, Mom. It's a car.
Yeah. Okay.
That's all right. That'll work.
Well, let Mama get my damn shorts on and let's get these groceries out.
All right.
I'm going to go sit up here, okay?
All right.
Jacob has always been my big helper. Pick stuff up off the floor to carry my groceries in, pick heavy stuff up, move stuff around. But lately, I've noticed that he's been getting winded. And... it really concerns me.
You know, baby, I thought you'd be able to get it a little quicker than that.
Yeah, well, if you're helping.
I'm worried about his health. It's no longer, oh, he's just a big boy. No, now he's a big boy with big issues.
I pull up with groceries, you'll be, and you're 18 years old. It concerns me as a mom to see you in that kind of health. You used to ride bikes all day, every day. Now, would you ride a bicycle?
No, because it's just too much.
That is unacceptable. I failed you as a mother. I did.
My mom has a point. I can definitely see myself getting out of breath and, you know, being tired of small things. Being my size, I have pain in my back and I gotta try and like lay down sometimes and maybe that helps. I also have trouble getting into like cars and stuff like that, you know. It's definitely a problem.
I have to go see Dr. Proctor. How would you feel about going with me and get weighed?
I could see about it, yeah. I think I could, you know, go with you, I guess.
I don't want Jacob to feel like it's okay to be this big. I don't want Jacob to have to deal with the pain that comes with being overweight. I am scared to death for him.
We have to do something. We have to. I love you, baby.
I love you too.
I really do.
Time to face the music.
Hello.
Hey, how you doing?
Good. I got an appointment with Dr. Proctor.
Hey. All right, I'll go ahead and check you guys in. Y'all can have a seat and I'll be with you shortly.
All right, come on, baby. Let's
see. I'm here to see him too. Yeah. All right.
Today is my 1 year post-operation check-in with Dr. Proctor, and I will be honest, I am afraid because I have not been keeping up with the eating habits that I first maintained the first 6 months, and I'm afraid it's gonna show. I don't know if to be nervous because he's so fine and I'm nervous because he looks good, or if I'm nervous because of the scale. You know, I thought about asking Dr. Proctor to record his voice for me so I can put it on my refrigerator anytime I open the refrigerator up.
You want him to record
up.
His voice for you so you can do it every night.
There's something about Dr. Proctor, okay? Those dimples and those eyes. I could just eat him up.
For me, he'd have to be blackened, flipped, and seasoned for me.
You want him good and seasoned?
Good and seasoned.
Meghan, the doctor is ready for you.
Knowing that I'm about to have to step on that scale, I have a lot of things going through my head.
Have a seat.
I'm worried, have I gained? Have I not lost enough? But I'm scared.
Hey there.
Hey.
How are you?
I'm good, I guess. I'm good, glad to see you.
That doesn't sound very good.
No, I've been a little anxious to see you, to be honest.
I hear you. You went into surgery around, what, 440 pounds?
That's 440, yeah.
Yeah, so here we are 1 year out. It's kind of time to see where things sit.
It's been about 6 months since my last weigh-in with Dr. Proctor at 331. I should have lost 30 or 40 more pounds by now, but I haven't been sticking to my diet 100%. That's why I've been avoiding the scale. And now it's like, do or die.
329 pounds.
I've done it up, and it sucks to be slapped in the face with something like that.
So it's been 6 months now since you were last here, and you've really lost no weight whatsoever. It doesn't make any sense after the type of operation you had that you're not gonna lose any weight. There's something wrong here. Meghan having stalled out in the last 6 months is very concerning for me. This tells me she's not doing the things that she's supposed to do. She's not putting any effort into this. So we've gotta get to the bottom of what's going on.
I think one of my problems is not eating frequently enough. And I don't think I'm getting enough protein.
Well,
and then I don't drink enough fluids. And I'm not moving enough. What would be a good amount of calories?
Meghan's given me a lot of excuses. She's talked about why she thinks her weight loss has stalled, and I can tell she's just sort of running around trying to, for me not to get angry with her, but the reality is Meghan's just wasted her last 6 months. She doesn't have time for excuses. At some point, she's gonna have to figure out if she wants to live or die.
Bariatric surgery is not something that just will just sort of help you forever. Once your body is satisfied that you're at your new normal, you're not gonna lose any more weight.
You maybe have another year left.
Okay.
And guess what? You can gain all that weight back. You can go right back to where you were before. Look at those pictures. Mm-hmm. Look at that woman that came in a year and a half ago on oxygen who could barely move. You gotta make a choice now. Which direction are you gonna go with your life?
I never in a million years want to ever get back to where I was. That's not a kind of life you wanna live. That's not living. That's just existing.